And I thought, it's mine, I need it, give it to me now. So yeah. Hello my beauties and welcome to my channel. If you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki, I'm 43 from the Netherlands, hence the accent. And today is my monthly favorite of May. Yes, well, let me go and sit well. So yes, what I just grabbed is the stuff that I really am really loving this month. I have one fail. I even have a hair care product. who knew? What I'm going to do is I'm going to do a separate video on my haul and then probably a review roundup video. Yes, that's the plan. Oh, and excuse the noise outside. I don't know what they are doing. So if you hear anything, it's that. Let me start with, well, the fail. So we have that out of the way. And that is actually this, the e.l.f. 16 Hour Camo Concealer. I have mine in the color medium peach. It is not a complete fail. It is, however, a fail concealer-wise. I have it on again today. I used a tiny, tiny amount. It is just too heavy of a formula for me. So it cakes up really, really quickly. And I could kind of save it with a product I will name a little bit later in the video. But yeah, no, it's not me. Not for underneath my eyes. However, so it is a fail in the under eye concealer category. However, I really do like this for cutting the crease. Because it is a little bit thicker, a little bit more sticky. It dries down very nicely and pretty quickly. But yeah, I don't know what it is, but I freaking love this as a cut crease eye primer stuff thing like that. So that is how I use it. So it's kind of a weird one because it's a fail and then kind of a favorite as well. But it is sometimes, yeah. Yeah, so that was my fail and then, yeah, no, you know, yeah. Let's go to something freaking random because, yeah, we're going into the favorites. The favorite is my mug. Look, crazy cat lady. It is so me. I needed a new coffee mug. And then when I went to Keltfest, I saw this and I thought, it's mine, I need it, give it to me now. So yeah. Just a random favorite. I have no freaking idea where you can get it. I don't know. But it is a favorite. Then let's go to hair. Yes, it's weird, isn't it? As you see, I am blonde. I am not naturally blonde. I have some new people, so let me explain. I'm not a natural blonde, no. I am actually, well, quite dark. So I bleach my hair and I usually when, because I'm kind of darker brown, when I bleach my hair, I do it myself. I mix everything myself. It can kind of tend to get a little bit yellow, you know. That is why it is looking a little bit yellowy now, because I've bleached it for the first time again and then shaved off the end parts, you know, so made it a little bit shorter. So that is why it's kind of yellowish now again. My favorite product to kind of combat that, besides bleaching again, which I need to do every week, it's because my hair is short, is this one from Kruidvat. Kruidvat is a Dutch store. This is a wash-in, wash-out color shampoo. But it is anti-yellow. It is very, very purple. I don't know if you can see. I have it here on my hand. Oh, now it's looking more black. But it is very, very purple. And that is the color I need. We have, we call it the silver shampoo. I don't know if that's what you call it as well. But we have kind of two kinds, you know. We have one that is a little bit more blue. And then we have one that is a little bit more purple. I need the purpley one to combat the yellowness that I have in my hair. If my hair is more on the reddish side, I kind of need the blue. You know, this is fantastic stuff. This is, says it holds up to 3 washings. So how I use it, if I'm very dirty, sunscreen, you know, because I use sunscreen here as well. I spray sunscreen on top of my head. I wash my head slash hair first with regular shampoo. Then I use this one, and you kind of need to use it as a hair mask as well. So leave it in for like 5 minutes. So it's probably something like a toner. And I use that, and I tend to use it almost every time that I wash or shower to really help, you know, get rid of that yellowness. Oh, and I tried a lot of silver shampoos, and this is actually the first one that really, really nicely works. So how I use it also, when I just bleach my hair, I rinse out the bleach and then I put this in. And then after I have let this one sit for 5 to 10 minutes and I wash that out, I kind of do a hair mask or something like that. Not specifically for my hair, but more for my scalp, you know. So yeah, I really, really like this. So if you live in the Netherlands or you have a Kruidvat near you and you are looking for a good silver shampoo, try this one. It was €2 for a bottle like this. You don't need a lot. It contains 75 milliliters and I freaking love the stuff. So yeah. That was my hair care. Yes. I have a combination of drugstore and high-end for my favorites, which is fun. So let's kind of start with order of application then. For primer, I have 2 favorites this month. I have this one from Catrice, which is the 1 minute... What is it called? Face Perfector. It is such a nice product, this. It's a moussey texture. When you put it on, you can kind of, you know, it has a little bit of a tint, but when you spread it on, you can see your skin blurring, which is really, really nice. And I like to use this sometimes on its own, but usually now in combination with something else. And the something else is this one from Fenty Beauty, the Pro Filter, what is it called? Instant Retouch Primer in Soft Matte. I got this sent to me by one of you, and I've been using it every single day. So I use this one first. I use, I think, about 2 pumps for my whole face, and I bring it down my neck as well. It doesn't blur for me, but it just makes my face sticky in a way that grips everything that I put on top of it. So a lot of the time I use this on its own underneath my foundation, and it is really, really pretty. But I can also nicely layer this one on top on the days that I want very light coverage and just, you know, don't feel like doing a foundation and just want everything to smooth out a bit. It's just fantastic. And I really like this. I don't really know if it makes my makeup last any longer. I feel it does. But just the fact that it kind of makes my, especially here, my cheeks a little bit sticky. So it grips my foundation really, really well. That is what I want in a primer. I don't really care if it blurs or not, because I can use this one to blur. But yeah, it is a favorite primer. I don't have any okays. I just have favorites from now. So just so you know. Okay, let's go to foundation then next. Because I actually rediscovered one that I thought I did not really like. I went through my foundations, I think 2 weeks back. And I was like, you know, I kind of need to see if I need to get rid of some, that some may have gone bad, you know. And of course film it, because yeah, it's... and I found this one again, the Catrice HD Liquid Coverage Foundation. Everyone is, and their mother are raving about this. I have a foundation review on it. And it was actually my first kind of negative review on a foundation, because at the time that I tested it, which was last year, it was so hit or miss for me. If I had a hit, it looked very, very pretty. But if I had a miss, it looked very bad. So yeah, I was not a fan of this foundation. Granted, my skin was not in a good, or in as good a place as it is now. And I did not use primer. So maybe that is it as well. I don't know what changed. But I'm freaking loving this foundation. It is nice and thin. It is thinner than the one that I have from Primark. And the one from Primark is getting a little bit... I still freaking love the stuff. But it's getting a little bit too thick now. You know that the weather is getting warmer. I love this. It gives very nice coverage. It plays so beautifully with that Fenty primer. It is just insane. So I freaking love this stuff. I have mine in the color Warm Beige now, which is the darkest one I can get here in store where I live. So yeah, second skin effect, yeah, for me now it definitely is. So yeah, I love the foundation. The concealer that I really, really love is also from Catrice. It's the One Drop Weightless Coverage Concealer. It's the same kind of cute, it's a cute bottle with a dropper and glass. It's very cute. This is the color 010, and I have 2 colors. I have 010 and I have 020. This one is actually too light for me at the moment, but this one has a bit more of a pinkish undertone. And the other one that I have is more of a yellowy undertone. And now that I am kind of getting a little bit of a tan, even though I wear sunscreen every freaking day, my skin gets a little bit more yellowy undertone, and I can use that yellowy concealer better now than when I'm a bit paler. I do want to get a darker one of these. The only trouble is that I kind of need to see which one I need then. This is a very light formula, but it packs quite a punch. I really like this. It does not cake up underneath my eyes. I just use a drop on my finger, then do that, and then just, you know, tap it out. If I need a little bit more, I take a little bit more. This is, how many mils? Do I know? Oh, 7 milliliters. And I think I can use this for a very, very long time, because literally you only need one drop. I can also use it on the days that I'm not wearing foundation to just kind of help, you know, even out some extra stuff. And that is also why I want one that is more in my skin tone now, so I can kind of use it like that, you know? Fantastic concealer. Next, to set that, I have a specific under eye powder, which is from Root Cosmetics, which is the under eye setting powder mineral. It is a bit, I don't know if you can see that, a little bit translucent. No, pearlescent, that was the word I was looking for. It's very, very fine. It's a small container. Oh, of course, it comes with a sifter. Very fine powder. You don't need a lot of it. When I just got it, I was like, I don't know if I like it, but I think I used too much, because you only need a tiny bit. So I just kind of dip my brush in like that, tap off excess, and then I go to powder my under eyes. And if I think that I need a little bit more, I need a little bit more. It sets my concealer very, very nicely. It does not cake up on me unless I use too much. Even today, did I use it today? No, I used a different powder today because my under eyes were caking anyway. If I use a cakey concealer and I use this, it does tend to cake up a little faster on me. But overall, it is a very, very nice powder. I can highly, highly recommend it. And it was not expensive either. So yeah, so let's segue into the next powder, which is a little bit more expensive, which is what I used today. And it kind of helped combat the cakiness that is my base today. So who knew that a powder could do that? And it is this one, the Hourglass Veal Mineralized. Oh no, it's not mineralized. Translucent setting powder. This stuff though, I know why so many people love this. I got this sent to me as well, because I know I did not buy it. I got it sent to me as well from one of you guys, and I'm so freaking happy that you sent it, because it actually saved my base today. My base is not looking really good. But when I put this one on, and I just used it to set today, I did not use it to buff. I set underneath my eyes with it as well. I set my face. It gives a nice kind of a glow from within. It just made my base look not cakey, which I am blown away about. So if you can afford this, yeah, do so, because I don't know how long this will last me. From this, I just need such a tiny amount, and then it kind of leaves my face feeling a little bit tacky, but the rest that I put over it blends so nicely. I don't need more than just a tiny bit, so I can highly, highly recommend. And this is so good. Then let's go to my favorite bronzer at the moment, which is this from Maybelline, the City Bronzer in color 200, which was also sent to me by one of you. This is, I could use it as a contour. I don't contour, but I love this color on me. So yeah, it just gives me a nice sun-kissed look, not a burned look, but a sun-kissed look. And I think it's really, really pretty. I have it on today, and especially when I use it on top of the hourglass, everything I then kind of blend over, it gets a nice sheen, you know. I love a sheeny blush. I also love a sheeny highlighter. That's no bronzer. That sounds weird, but you know what I mean, you know. It's a very, very, very nice color. Can I swatch it? Sure. I don't know if you can see it though. I don't know. It is just a tiny bit darker than my skin tone, but it is so pretty. So yeah, thank you again for sending this to me. Then next I have another high-end product. Natasha Denona Diamond and Glow, the pinky one. This is so pretty. So pretty. First off, I love the packaging. But when you feel this, it is so buttery. I don't have any alternatives for this. So how do I use it? Here you have the two shades. This one for me as a blush, or the pinky one for me as a blush, is too light at the moment. It does not really show up as a blush, but I use it as a blush topper. So today I kind of went like that with my brush, use both shades, and then use it as a highlighter and a blush topper, just two in one. But it is so pretty. It is a little bit of a glittery formula, especially the white one. So if you do not like that, maybe you won't like this one. And it is fantastic. I did not have a lot, but I have been talking for forever. So let's speed it up, shall we? Okay. Eye pencil. BH Cosmetics Power Pencil in Teal. This is such a good pencil. This glides on like a dream. I'm tempted to use it every single look that I do. I wish that BH would do more funky colors. This is the regular teal, not the shimmery one. Highly, highly recommend. It stays all freaking day. It is so pretty. I want it in my waterline now, so let's just do that. I know I have a pencil on already, but as you can see, it glides on with minimal effort. And if you feel that it is a bit too dry, just do a swatch on your hand, you know, then you kind of scrape off the top layer and then it works like a charm. Last thing for the eyes, and then I have two lippies and then we're done, is this one. The IT Cosmetics Hello Lashes. This is a mini. I don't know if the mini is the same quality as the large one, but oh my lord, this is such a fantastic mascara. I got this scent as well because I got a very nice big box sent by one of you. I will link the video down below. This is such a good mascara. On days that I use this, I don't wear falsies. I don't have falsies on today. I don't need them with this mascara. So yeah, very, very nice. It does not flake during the day. If I do one coat, it's nice. If I do two coats, it's better. Today I have two coats of this one and then a few coats of a blue one to make my lashes blue, which did not work. So yeah, just so you know. Anyway, yes, let's go to the next category, which is lips. Let's start with this one, which is still my favorite lip gloss. The NYX Intense Butter Gloss in Cookie Butter. I have it on the lips today. Fantastic. I have two now. And I unfortunately cannot get it here in store. So yeah, I will probably be very, very sad when it is gone. But yeah. What can you do about it? Not much really. Okay. Fantastic color. I love the formula. It has been my favorite for a few months. And then let's go to my favorite liquid lipstick formula at present. Is the L'Oreal Color Rouge. No, Rouge Signature. That's it. I have three of these. I have a light. It is a very pale orangey nude. And then I have more of an orange, and then I have this one, which is more of a brown. I love the color as well. It's actually my favorite color, and the formula is amazing. It is such a thin formula, and it packs a punch. It stays for a long, long time. I love this formula. Favorite formula. It's not gloopy. It is, what do I have here? Oh yes, I think I'm kind of breaking out. Yes, I put a primer on that I think I need to throw away because I think it's not good anymore and it's kind of breaking me out, so that's not good. Anyway, that's not really important. Fantastic, fantastic, fantastic. Highly recommend. And that was it for my favorites video of this month. Yes, I mentioned some other products like that blue mascara and that primer, but you cannot get them anymore. So it does not really matter, you know. Those two are two products that I have in my house for a very long time. So yeah, it's not really that important to mention. So yeah, that was it. That was it for my favorites and fails of the month of May. Let me know down below some of your favorites and fails, and maybe you have tried some of the stuff that I have. Let me know what you think of it. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. Oh, I did film the look though. I had on a different lippy before I started this video. I had on a blue one, took that off and put the nude one on. It is the second look with the Zephyr palette from 5050 Makeup, which is coming. I don't know when exactly. It should be, I hope it's this week or it will be next week, but it is coming. Just so you know, a lot of things are coming because I have a lot of stuff to get through. So yeah, if you like the video, give it a thumbs up. I don't know if I already said that though. Yeah. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button before you leave. And yeah, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in my next one. Bye guys.